In this problem, there are three ropes connected to one concurrent point holding a 25-pound bucket. And we want to know the tension in the three ropes attached to the overhead frame. At this point, let's isolate the bucket and create a free body diagram. The bucket is isolated by cutting a line through the rope and adding a vector to show how the rope holds the bucket in equilibrium. At this point, it is important to remember that the sum of the forces must equal zero in order to keep the bucket in equilibrium. The weight from the bucket is being pulled through the center of mass by gravity, which must be resisted by an equal force in the opposite direction in order to maintain equilibrium. So the force on the rope is 25 pounds. Now that the bucket is isolated, let's look at the system again. The rope holding the bucket is attached to the steel ring. Two other ropes attached to the ring pull upward to keep this isolated system in equilibrium. The force Ty from the first free body diagram is flipped when applied to the rope connected to the ring. This makes sense when looking at the ropes tied to the ring. All three ropes pull along their line of action. The intersection of these lines locate the concurrent point for the three forces. To compute the tension in the ropes, draw the free body diagram of the concurrent point and show the three forces. Drop everything else from the drawing. Add the coordinate system and identify the remaining two tension forces. Draw in the force vectors, assuming that the ropes can only pull on the ring. Notice the tensions TA and TB are at an angle. Right now, you may be asking yourself, well, how am I going to solve this now? Don't give up just yet. There are three methods to solving these type of problems. Trigonometric method, closed polygon method, and ratio method. The first method uses trigonometry to find the directions of each vector and the magnitude of its components. Go back to look at the simple geometry, measure some distances, and solve for the angle of the ropes. These dimensions fit a right triangle. Using trig, let's solve for the angle theta. Solving for the angle of the rope also gives us the angle of the tension force because the line of action must be in the direction of the rope. So solve for the angle of the other rope as well. Now include these angles on the free body diagram. Then use the equilibrium equations to solve for the tensions. First, break the tension forces down to x and y components. Remember that components replace the tension forces without changing the system. It makes it easier to sum the forces in the x and y direction. Keep track of directions by including negative signs because the sum of the forces must equal zero. It looks like two equations with four unknowns. But substituting the trig functions reduces this to just two unknowns, TA and TB. And now do some algebra and trig. Substitute the angles and solve for tension TB. Then substitute to solve for tension TA. With these values, solve for the components to check the answer. Verify that the sum of the forces equals zero. Return to the original tension forces in the ropes to complete this problem. The second method is an extension of the parallelogram method that creates a closed vector polygon reflecting the force equilibrium. The method uses trigonometry as well to find the directions of each vector as shown in the trig method. Then, using the principles of the parallelogram method, the vectors are realigned to form a closed polygon. But it is important to remember that the vectors cannot be moved from the line of action, so the orange vectors indicate that these vectors are out of alignment. Review videos on concurrent points and parallelogram method for more detail. Now relate the angles we found earlier to the angles in the polygon. All the interior angles can be found in this problem. Now the magnitude of vector TA can be found using the law of sines. And the magnitude of vector TB. Since the vectors formed a closed polygon, the sum of the forces in the x direction must equal zero and the sum of the forces in the y direction must equal zero. Knowing the magnitudes of the vectors means we know the tensions in the ropes, which completes this problem. The third method is the ratio method that uses similar triangles relating geometry to vector directions. Measurements are still required, but this time compute the hypotenuse of the right triangle using the Pythagorean theorem. Return to the free body diagram of the ring and draw the vector components. Now the vector components are related to the tension in the rope by the ratio of the right triangle showing the geometry of the rope. The ratio TBY divided by the right side of the triangle must equal the ratio of TB divided by the hypotenuse of the triangle. Try writing the ratios with forces on top and lengths on the bottom. When solving for one force, notice that the feet units cancel. You're left with a scalar value. Do the same for TBX. Now we have TBX and TBY in terms of the tension TB. Do the same for TAX and TAY. It looks like six unknowns, but the equilibrium equations take care of this. Make sure that the components have the correct signs. Solve for TA, then substitute. solve for TB, then compute TA. Now we know the tension in the ropes which complete this problem.